This is Luke Katsos, and I'm so happy to be here at the Russian Tea Room for an event that we're having now in partnership with the Greater Harlem Chamber of Commerce. It's the fourth Hellenic Rembetika Harlem Blues concert. Right now, people are starting to come into the cocktail hour at this iconic location and venue. I'm so glad to see one of our friends here tonight, John Katsimatidis. John.
I know the one thing you do that is always terrific is putting people together. And that's what it's all about. It's a great accomplishment. Thank you for what you do.
No, thank you, John. Thank you. And we're so happy to be here, by the way. It's fantastic. And post-COVID, because we always used to do an event on a yearly basis with the Greater Harlem Chamber of Commerce. And now we're resurrecting that. And the stars are aligning for this particular event, because not only are we doing the fourth concert together with the Greater Harlem Chamber of Commerce and EMBCA, the East Mediterranean Business Cultural Alliance, but also we decided to celebrate the fact that we have the 50th year anniversary of Harlem Week. We want to promote the new national Harlem Museum of Jazz.
Winston Majette, Greater Harlem Chamber of Commerce Executive Director. I am so proud to be here with our Chamber Board member, Mr. Lou Katsos, and we're celebrating Black Music Month, and we're going to have great Greek music and Harlem jazz music. So, if you get a chance, come down to the Russian Tea Room so you can have your own great experience like we're having at the Greater Harlem Chamber of Commerce.
And we also want to celebrate the moving back of the Acropolis castings that are moving back into Harlem, to CCNY, the City University of New York, where they were originally located. These are the castings that were taken on the original marbles in the 1840s and donated to the City College of New York for their art department. And now they're coming back. For us, metaphorically, it almost symbolizes for us the marbles that are in London being brought back to Athens where they belong and where they were stolen in the early 1800s. So enjoy the event with us. And like I said, the people are coming in. We're gonna have a great time tonight. We're gonna start with the cocktail hour, then we're going to the music.
We'd like to welcome you to the fourth Hellenic Rembetika. I'm learning a little bit from the Harlem Blues concert. EMBCA and the Greater Harlem Chamber of Commerce welcome you to this partnership. This is a fabulous room, isn't it, ladies and gentlemen? Tonight's performers, the Hellenic Ensemble with soprano Julie Ziavras. And Petros Hatjopoulos. I was close on that. We'll be performing this evening. And Harlem's renowned Phil Young Jazz Quartet. This time, I'd like to bring up our Greater Harlem Chamber of Commerce Executive Vice President. You all know him, he's fantastic. He's Mr. Louis Katsos.
Yes!
Thank you so much. Thank you all for being here today. It's a special event. This is the fourth event we're having together. The East Mediterranean Business Cultural Alliance, in partnership with the Greater Harlem Chamber of Commerce. Everybody here knows each other because we've done this more than once. We decided in this particular year to have a special venue. Because before, as you know, we used to do these events on a yearly basis. We used to do it at St. Peter's. We decided to do a special occasion. And the stars aligned in June, by the way. Because we were We actually produced a concert with my friend Ali Kaçak, which is the Turkish and Hellenic concert that we did in April. And at the audience was Boza Rivers. When I saw Boza, it reminded me of the first time we discussed these events. And it was in Harlem. It was at the Dinosaur. Everybody was jumping. It was a Christmas party. I saw Boza by a column. I go up to Boza. I said, Boza, this is fantastic. Why don't we do a concert together? He said, what do we call it? I said, let's do HH, Hellenic Harlem. And that was the beginning of the first concert. This particular concert, when I say the stars align, I mean, we were saying, okay, we want to do it at a special venue. We want to have a tight crowd that we know each other very well because we've known each other for decades in many cases. And we decided, what was happening around now? The 50th anniversary of Harlem Week. And we said, what a fantastic 50th anniversary of Harlem Week. At the same time, we wanted to support a permanent residence for the National Jazz Museum in Harlem. And then the third thing that came to my mind, which really links the Hellenic aspect and the Harlem aspect, is the bringing back of the Acropolis castings to Harlem at City College of New York. What are these castings? These castings were made in the 1840s on the original marbles. And basically, they were donated in 1852 to City College. They went to the Onassis Center for a while, and it's time for them to come back. For us, what does it symbolize? It symbolizes the Acropolis marbles, which are in London, which must go back to Athens, their indigenous place of origin. So everything works out. Thank you all for being here. Let's enjoy the evening.
Wow. You were such a dull, boring guy. He and I actually talked about this in Cuba together. So I'm glad it's coming to fruition, because you're a good guy. Now I'd like to tell you a little bit more about Harlem Week. Harlem Week started 50 years ago as a one-day event when folks like Boza Rivers and Tony Rogers said they wanted to do something with Percy Sutton and Lloyd Williams to bring the community up in a great spirit. In 1974, the Daily News posted something from President Ford for New York City to drop dead. We're not going to help you do that.
Wow.
So, great group of people came together and said, well, we're going to do something. We're going to change what was at that time called 7th Avenue, renaming Adam Clayton Powell Jr. Boulevard, the first time an African American. So the Great Harlem Chamber of Commerce in Harlem, we, you know, being as lazy as we are, we decided, okay, let's make this 2 days. Let's make all the week 3 days. Let's make it a week. And then brilliant people like Lou Castle said, trademark. Make a trademark. The next thing you know, G.P. Alexander, we were doing 28 days of Harlem Week in July. So here we are, 50 years later, bringing it to you, the local, state, and international event called Harlem Week. So remember, August the 3rd through August the 18th, we have about 104 events, virtual and live. So make sure you go to www.harlemweek.com and find out what we are doing. Oh, this gentleman is fantastic. He is a good friend on our chamber board. And he's going to give you remarks about the National Jazz Museum in Harlem. Let me introduce to you Richard Taffer, the chairman of the National Jazz Museum.
And good evening, everybody. I just want to make clear, I don't go anywhere without Tracy Leiter Sumner. Giving the good advocacy for the museum. And, you know, I've prepared no remarks other than to say, to follow up on some comments that Lou made, that we are and we have in the back of our mind to be able to build a permanent home in Harlem for the National Jazz Museum in Harlem. And I'm sitting here tonight, you know, we're here with Tracy, we're here with Robin Bell Stevens from Jazzmobile. Yeah. Steal something from what Tracy said last week.
You better not.
that one of our co-artistic directors always says that if jazz was born in New Orleans, it had some good years up in Harlem to mature. So one of the things we are trying and we're working hard, and I am going to turn the mic over to Tracy in a second, but we are really establishing the museum as a foundational institution and beyond. And it's not just the music, it's clearly the music, but it's also the fact that it is a cultural institution, it's an educational institution, it's an economic institution. What I always like to say, and Tracy will give you the data, the number of musicians who have played in the museum over the past year or two is in the thousands, and everyone gets paid. And it's a way to keep the music alive. Now, usually what I try to say right now is go to jmih.org to find donate, push the button, and put down a lot of zeros before to the left of the period. No, but we need your support, and we really appreciate the chamber. We appreciate Lou and having us here. Let me let Tracy actually tell you what's really important.
As Richard stole my opening line, I will give you the data. In the past 2 years, we've educated over 24,000 pre-K to 12 graders in jazz. Wow. We have employed over 1,500 artists in the past year. And one of the things I'm proudest of is that since 2022, 50% of the artists, scholars, and presenters at the museum are women. How many people have been to the National Jazz Museum in Harlem? That's not enough. Coolest hang in Harlem except for Jazz Museum. We're at 58 West 129th Street, and as Richard said, we host some of the most famous jazz artists in the world, and we host some of the most soon-to-be-famous jazz artists in the world. And some of the evidence of that is John Batiste. Does everybody know who he is? Yeah. Who, with Christian McBride, is not only one of our artistic directors, but John used to come to the Jazz Museum and perform and play and create programming when he was at Juilliard. So we like to take credit for what he does. Come up to visit, to see what we do, and to see the music that you love, whatever that music is, reflected in the work that we do. Thank you.
Whatever you like, we call that.
He's the executive music producer for Harlem Week. He's also the chairman of the Arts and Cultural Committee for the Greater Harlem Chamber of Commerce. He is the great bouzouki.
Thank you. Good evening to all. This is really special for us that we're here during the month of June because, as it has been mentioned, June is Black Music Month. And Black Music Month gives us an opportunity to continue to connect our culture, to share it, and not only to share it, but to produce and present. We have been fortunate that through Harlem Week, we've had some of the greatest entertainers of color performing for us. But most importantly is that our reach has expanded significantly, where we are in the millions of people during our Harlem Week period, that we are touching their lives, we are presenting quality presentations all across the country. So for me, this is special that Lou, Lloyd, and both organizations decided that this is the month that we would be here with all of you. So again, enjoy the evening. Thank you.
Introduce the Hellenic Ensemble with soprano Julie Ziavras, joined by Petros Hatjopoulos and Kostas Psarros. Part of the reason why we call this the Hellenic Rembetika and the Harlem Blues concert is because the Rembetika are the Hellenic Blues, and some of the themes that we talk about in terms of the Harlem Blues are similar in the Greek music. The genre is different, obviously, but all the themes are exactly the like, and the instruments, of course, are a little bit different. Due to this particular month, being also the 50th anniversary of the brutal and continuing occupation of Cyprus, two of the songs that we'll be playing tonight will be in commemoration and a tribute to Cyprus. Thank you. Julie, please.
They may have taken you, but I have you also. I hold the key deep within my heart. And as the more years pass, the deeper the wound.
Thank you. Thank you. Oh, Thank you.
waitress. This waitress knows how to play the room. She gives a little bit of hors d'oeuvres. She puts a little water in the wine so people don't get too fresh. She knows what she's doing because everybody leaves very happy.
Thank you. Ladies and gentlemen, please put your hands together. We're going to welcome to this stage a young lady who is extremely talented. She's been around the world a couple of times doing what she's going to do for you right now. So would you put your hands together and welcome to the stage.
eyes on you. And everybody said that you were through. I took you in, made you strong again, put you back together out of all the dreams you left along the way. You left me shining. Now you're doing well. From stories I can tell, you own the world again. Everyone's your friend. Although I never hear from you, still it's nice to know. You must be.
Give it up again. Really young. And now, as Fuller mentioned, I'd like to bring up President for the Greater Harlem Chamber of Commerce, who just in the 50 years of celebrating Harlem Week, he has done so much for people, economic development, senior citizens.
You saying no?
No.
You saying no?
Okay. Because I would have been up here a long time because of the many, many, many accomplishments just over 50 years that our president, Mr. Lloyd Williams, has.
Because they all sing the background. How about that?
Thank you very much.